what we saw that we thought was really interesting that was going to be worthwhile. All of a sudden, it just kind of became me and just me, and it was just like my little area. So I started thinking about how I grew up, stuff that I always loved that I'd never seen as an ice cream, stuff that sounds like a terrible idea. And little by little, that's come into play. I wanted our ice cream to be an entire dessert. I didn't want it to be like vanilla chocolate or strawberry. That's boring. I wanted every dessert that I've ever loved, out of every cuisine that I could think of, anything that's super weird and great, I wanted you to have like a scoop of dessert. I wanted to do a banana praline pie is where it started. And it was banana ice cream with the praline pecans and then chunks of pie crust. And then from there, it kind of went, well, what if we do, it wasn't selling. So I was like, okay, so we're gonna make something else banana. So we'll do a different pie. We always had to have a pie flavor. That's how we started. It's always a pie ice cream. And then it sort of like went from pie to, okay, well, what if we do like a cinnamon praline? And we had this like super long, stupid name for it when it was really just like vanilla cinnamon ice cream and the praline pecans. And one of my ice cream girls was like, it tastes like a Mexican wedding cookie. Like, done.
My name is Michael Tai. I am the production manager for a restaurant and factory Creamery. 31 years old and been with the company about 6 months now, so still kind of new to it, but loving every minute. I guess the thing I like most about my job is you never see someone upset eating ice cream, and that to me is a really rewarding feeling. You know, just knowing that we make as a team, everybody that comes into the restaurant leave with a smile. You know, it's, I guess, just a cup of goodness that everyone can kind of take with them, and that makes me happy to be a part of that and to see that side.
That's so cool to be that guy. It's like being a local celebrity without all the stress of being known by your face.
And it is. It's something that happens. I get off of work, get my Hub t-shirt, and go run errands, and that's, oh, we work at Hub, we love their ice cream, it's so great. You know, it's great to get that community feedback and then to know that what we're doing is not only providing for the community and giving back to the community with some of the charitable things that we do, but that extends into the product that we bring into the store. Again, going back to fair trade certified, organic when we can, and locally sourced ingredients as close to home as we possibly can. That gives back to our community. Our state, the people that support us, we in turn are supporting them in what we do. So it's very rewarding from that standpoint.
Yeah, I definitely agree. By looking in here, that we're not ready. See how it's still pretty dark? So for each batch of ice cream, it's anywhere between 8 minutes and 16, depending on what size batch we pour in here. We can only put a maximum of 12 minutes worth of ice cream base into the machine for it to fit to the final batch of 6 gallons. It's like 3 gallons go in, 6 gallons comes out. But what we look for, our ice cream is classified as premium, which means that it has the least amount of air in the product and a very high fat content. So it's denser than gelato. Well, it's on par dense wise with gelato, but it has way more fat. Right now, this is our dark chocolate. We have 3 different chocolates that go into it. So we have like a really, really dark, rich cocoa powder that we use that we cook down to like almost pudding with a little bit of sugar and water. And then we add that to and that is our, basically our base chocolate for anything that we put. So everything goes into that chocolate. And we'll use this ice cream base to do the next three flavors. So this one's gonna be, we have chocolate covered. So this is chocolate and peanut butter coated Rice Krispies. And they're gonna get mixed in. And then we have a bunch of miniature, they're like Reese's peanut butter chips. That get mixed in. So instead of having like the normal chocolate peanut butter ice cream, we try to come up with different ways to do it. So it's not boring. It's not always the same ingredients. We're getting a little closer. Check it again. See how it's a little bit better? How it's a little thicker? It's really close, but it's not quite there. It's definitely a little darker. -10 and -45 degrees. Try to keep it closer to -30, 22 to 30.